Hi everyone, today we are going to see about Homi K Bhabha. Homi K Bhabha was born on November 1, 1949 in India. He is an English scholar and critical theorist. So he was awarded the Padma Bhushan Award in the field of literature and education from the Indian government the year of 2012. Personal life. He is married to attorney and Harvard lecturer Jacqueline Bhabha and they have 3 children. He was born in Bombay, India into a Parsi family. Bhabha graduated with a BA from Elphinstone College at the University of Mumbai and the MA, MPhil and DPhil in English Literature from Christ College, Oxford University. In this page, we are going to see about the works of Homi K Bhabha. I have listed all his works, so I have highlighted the important works of Homi K Bhabha. The first he had written, Nation and Narration. It was written in the year of 1990 and this was one of the important work of Homi K Bhabha. So I am listing out all other works in short. A Good Judge of Character in a Spirit of Calm Violence. Then the fourth work, The Location of Culture in 1994, it is also one of the important work. And in this he has spoken about the hybridity and many of the key concepts which he had in his mind are opened up in that book. Then the remaining works I am reading out, Negotiating Rapture, Forward to Modernity, Conversational Art, Cosmopolitanism, On Cultural Choice, B.S. Nepal, Democracy Derealized, On Writing Rights, Making Difference, The Legacy of Cultural Wars, Adagio, Still Life, Forward to the Rich of the Earth, Edward Said, Continuing the Conversation, Framing, Without Boundary, The Black Servant and the Dark Princess, Our Neighbors, Ourselves, Anish Kapoor, Flammarion, Midnight to the Boom, Matthew Barney. These are the works which was written by Homi K Bhabha. Homi K Bhabha is one of the important figures in the contemporary post-colonial studies and has developed a number of the fields neologism and key concepts such as hybridity, mimicry, difference and ambivalence. Neologism. So it was a newly coined term. First let me explain what is that neologism. So he invented some of the terms such as mimicry, ambivalence. These were the terms in which he came out. Hybridity means it's a cross-cultural, that is a mixed of two culture here. Usually it was used to say about the mixture of two different plants or two different animals, but here they used to say about the mixture of two cultures. Then second one is mimicry. So mimicry is nothing but the imitations. So whenever we start to learn a language, we used to imitate the other language. During the colonial rule, Westerners came here and they tried to rule us. And they had given their language, their dress, their politics and their culture. And we tried to imitate their culture. And we consider ourselves as inferior. And so that we want to become them. And so we tried our level best to imitate them. So it is mimicry. Then the second one is, key concept is ambivalence. Ambivalence is nothing but the mixed feeling. He said, it is a state of having simultaneously conflicting reaction, belief or feeling towards some object. It is nothing but the mixed feeling. Then such term describe ways in which colonized people have resisted the power of colonizer, according to Homi K Bhabha. First, hybridity. So how Homi K Bhabha explained the term hybridity. So now let us see that. So before going into that, how the word hybridity came from. So one of the central idea is that of hybridization, which taking up from Edward Said's work describes the emergence of new cultural forms from multiculturalism. Instead of seeing colonialism as something blocked in past, Bhabha shows how its histories and culture constantly intrude on the present, demanding that we transform our understanding of cross-cultural relations. The word hybridization had taken from the Edward Said's work, and Edward Said describes the hybridization as the emergence of new cultural forms from multiculturalism. So Bhabha says, instead of seeing colonialism as something locked up in the past, instead of seeing, we usually see it as a negative aspect. We should not see in that aspect alone. Bhabha shows how histories and culture constantly intrude. Constantly intrude here means deliberately or falsely involved in the present and demanding that we transform our understanding of cross-cultural relations. So, it demands a cross-cultural relations. In other words, we can describe hybridity is a mixture of two or more identities. Hybridity can also be called as a mixture of linguistic, cultural, political, racial, social and religious combination. The second important concept Homi K Bhabha described is ambivalence. I already said about the ambivalence, it is a mixed feeling. It is a mixed feeling of two cultures. So in other words, we can say the simple presence of colonized other within the textual structure is enough evidence of the ambivalence of the colonial text, and ambivalence that destabilizes its claim for absolute authority or unquestionable authenticity. So here the main part of the ambivalence is it destabilizes its claim for absolute authority. Here absolute authority means the colonial power, the supreme colonial power, they claim to be superior. So they claim that other are inferior because they claim that they are superior. So this is the absolute authority or unquestionable authenticity. This speaks about the native culture. So usually the native people speak that they are the pure culture, that they are the original, and everything they claim that they are superior in their own way. So that unquestionable authenticity. So you should not question that. You should not question the purity. You should not question the tradition that they follow. So that thing should not be there. That destabilize, that ambivalence destabilize both this unquestionable authenticity and also the absolute authority. So absolute authority here it says that nobody is superior, nobody are inferior. All are equal, it says. Unquestionable authenticity, it always questions. Always question the foolish tradition followed by the native culture. So it gives a mixed feeling. So mixed feeling destabilizes. The main role of the ambivalence is destabilize two things, that is absolute authority or unquestionable authenticity. Next concept Bhabha describes is a cultural difference. Bhabha presents cultural difference as an alternative to cultural diversity. So he says it is an alternative. So cultural difference is an alternative to cultural diversity. The second point he had described about cultural diversity, a culture is an object of empirical knowledge and pre-exists the knower, while cultural difference sees culture as a point at which two or more cultures meet, and it is also where most problems occur. Discursively constructed rather than pre-given, a process of enunciation of culture as knowledgeable. So here in this point says it is a cultural diversity. He says it is an object of empirical knowledge. Empirical means some logical knowledge. So because of this we are doing. So like that it is based on the logical knowledge. But cultural difference, it's like two culture meeting up, the one or two culture meeting up on one point, and he also says there may be some problem added, there may be some problem comes while meeting up two culture.
When two or more culture meet, the problem will occur. But though the problem occur, it discursively construct rather than pre-given. So without leaving, it always construct itself. So that is the main thing. The next point is enunciation. Enunciation is the act of utterance or expression of a culture that takes place in the third space. Since culture is never pre-given, it must be uttered. It is through enunciation that culture difference is discovered and reorganized. The enunciative process introduces a divide between the tradition of a stable system of reference and the negation of certitude of culture in the articulation of new cultural meanings, strategies in the political presence as a practice of domination or resistance. Here says enunciation is act of utterance. Act of utterance here means it's an expression of culture that take place in the third space. Here it takes place in the third space. Since culture is never pre-given, it must be uttered. Never pre-given, it must be uttered means it must be spoken out. What are the culture and how they, what they do in their culture, it should be expressed. It is through enunciation that cultural difference is discovered and recognized. Here it says it is through expression. So only we speak about the culture, we can know about the differences in both the culture. Homi K Bhabha says that this enunciation, it breaks two things, that is the traditional culture and the new culture, that is a modern culture. The traditional culture, which always claimed that it is a pure culture, and the new culture, it claims that it is a superior culture. So here he says it divides both the things. All while discussing about the concept of post-colonial and the colonial, will always depend on the concept of fixity. So the fixity will come only while doing the construction of otherness. Fixity implies repetition, rigidity and unchanging order as well as disorder. Here implies means hindered. The fixity hindered repetition. So repeatedly doing something, rigidity. So being very firm in fixing up the culture, fixing up an ideology. So an unchanging order. Sometimes we cannot change something in the culture, that is unchanging order. Something as well as disorder. Sometimes it will be always in the disorder form. So it will also happen during the fixation of an ideology. The stereotype depends on this notion of fixity. The concept of fixity, the concept of stereotype completely depend on the notion of fixity. Notion here means ideology. The ideology of fixity. Fixing, this is the culture. This is the way we do. So we'll not do like this. We'll not do like that. They say, no, that is a fixity. The stereotype creates an identity that stems as much from mastery and pleasure as it does from anxiety and the defense of the dominant, for it is a form of multiple and contradictory belief in its recognition of difference and disavowal of it. The important aspect of stereotype creates an identity, and it have the mastery and pleasure from whatever it do, it get anxiety and defense of the dominant. The last important concept of Homi K Bhabha is third space. The third space develops when two or more culture meet up, or when two or more individual interact with each other. So in that manner, in that place, the third space comes up. At the end of the third space, Homi K Bhabha says that there is no purity in culture. So no culture can be claimed as a pure culture, and no culture can be claimed as a original culture. We cannot fix like that. The author, the Homi K Bhabha, tries to say is that. So anything can be translated, rehistorized and read anew. So we can read in a new manner, and we can translate it in a new manner. We can rehistorize that concept in a new manner. So he says nothing is pure and nothing is original. So everything they claim as a purity is invalid. He says that.
Thanks for watching. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe, like and comment our video. Thank you.